Mis siguientes invitados son grandes actores de la serie Sunnyside. Un fuerte aplauso para Kieran Deal y Samba Shoot. Con Platanito. Kieran, qué gusto conocerte. ¿Cómo estás?
Ah, it's so great to be here. Mucho gusto.
Mucho gusto. Mucho gracias gusto. Igualmente.
Yeah.
Oye, a ver, tú eres de la India, pero naciste en Inglaterra y te creaste en la Florida.
Yeah, I think that most people, I think a lot of people in Latin America too, and I'm sure you, we're all very global. We're very international people, but I actually think, yeah.
Hey.
Yeah. That's America now. That's America now. But the thing I found is that there's bullies everywhere. It doesn't matter if you're in India, it doesn't matter if you're in England, there's bullies everywhere. I grew up in Florida, and growing up there, I had a unibrow, and kids in middle school, they can be very mean. Like, there was this kid in middle school, and he was like, "You have a mustache." And so I ran home. You know, I didn't want to tell my mom about it because I didn't want to offend her about her beard. And then I just go into my dad's drawer and I bick the stash, like I shave off the mustache. I feel super great about it too. I feel super confident the next day and I go to school feeling very good. And the same guy was like, "Hey, you have a mustache." And so my best friend in the world was this dude. And he just looks at me and he goes, "Don't worry, Kieran, I'm gonna handle this." He looks at the bully and he just goes, "Hey, yo, no, she doesn't." She used to.
Oh, ya no.
But she shaved it off.
Oh,
yeah.
No. Yeah. Ay, ¿sabes qué? Que yo si te hubiera visto así, bigotana, yo no te hubiera hecho bullying por eso.
¿No?
No, yo te hubiera hecho bullying por esto. Vean esta fotografía. O sea, me la encontré. Esta es una foto de Kieran.
Uh-huh.
Oye, pero esta foto, ¿por qué? ¿Te dedicabas a ser clown?
So when I was like 7 or 8 years old, and my friend was having a birthday party, and they didn't want to hire real clowns. So they enlisted us, child labor, to do the clown work for 5-year-olds. So we were 8, and then they were like, "You do it." So then I painted my whole face. And then I pretended to be a clown, and I really got into it. I pretended I was from this whole clown world. I was lying to a whole group of 5-year-olds about, like, how it was a clown hobbit, and I, like, live in the underground world of clowns, and my wife was a clown. Like, this whole, like J.K. Rowling, but for clowns, you know? And then at the end of the whole thing, this kid looks at me, and he was like, "So when are you going to wash off your makeup so we can play?" I was like, no.
Ay, no, pues qué gusto tenerte aquí. Gracias.
Yeah, thank you for having me. This is so
Oye,
fun.
Y también gracias. Yeah. Y Samba también, bienvenido a Noches
gracias.
Con Platanito.
Thank you.
Oye, me gusta tu nombre, Samba.
Ah, thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Suena como buen bailarín.
Yeah, but I can't dance the samba. No. A lot of people come to me and they think, "Oh, your name is Samba."
Yeah.
I'm like, no.
I'm saying,
"Yeah, this is my sister salsa, my cousin cha-cha-cha, my cousin tango." But I can't dance the samba. How do you even do the samba? Is it just a... Is that okay?
Sí.
Yeah? Is that all right? All right.
Más all right. O menos, sí. Digo, bailaste como yo, más bien. Ahí está.
Okay, sí. Yeah. We can go to Brazil.
Yeah. Órale, vámonos. Sí. ¿Tú sabes bailar?
And then I have to get up and be like, and then I had to really get into it. So I have to be like, yeah, I can't really, that's it. That's it. I got it.
Échate algo de samba.
That's not bad. That's not bad. No, you got it.
We're really trying.
How do you do the samba? You have to move your feet, I think. I don't know.
Oye, a ver, Samba, platícame de ti. ¿Tú viviste en Etiopía?
Yes, I grew up in Ethiopia till I was 18. And I know a lot of people, when they see Ethiopia or they think of Ethiopia, they go, "I'm so sorry. Is that why you're skinny?" Like, no, this is genetic. You know, a lot of people see the images. It's true, we had a famine in the 80s, but in the capital city, it was a normal life, really good life. You know, we went to school normally. We grew up in a nice house. A lot of people don't know, but in Ethiopia, it's very normal for people to have help around the house, like someone to clean, someone to cook. So only when I moved to America did I realize how hard life is, because everyone's like, oh, I'm so sorry, you grew up in Ethiopia, it must be hard to come to America. I said, yeah, here I have to do everything myself. You know, who's going to wash the dishes and clean the house? You know, so it was a beautiful life in Ethiopia.
Oigan, y a ver, platíquenme algo. Ustedes que son actores y que viajan mucho, díganme, ¿qué les molesta a ustedes de viajar al extranjero?
I don't like immigration officers because they scare me.
Me too.
I think their job is to make you poop your pants. I 100% believe. Because what I speak English, yeah? But when I come face to face with an American immigration officer, I forget how to speak English. Like, because you hear that word, you hear, next. And you walk up, hi, hello, officer. What's the purpose of your visit? I love America. I can't get...
Bueno, pero ahora los que están intimidando a la gente son ustedes en esta gran comedia, Sunnyside.
Wow. Yeah.
Que precisamente trata de grupo de migrantes.
Yes, absolutely. So it's about a New York ex-councilman, a politician, who got fired. And now to make a job, he's hired by immigrants to help, teach them how to become American citizens.
Tú eres la hermana.
I'm the sister, and Cowpen is a fallen politician, so he's a real loser. You know, he's lost his job, and then he's lost his apartment, so he moves into the sister's apartment, to Mallory's apartment, and has to go look for a job, which is how he meets the immigrants.
Yeah.
Está divertidísima. No se lo pierdan todos los jueves a las 9:30, 8:30 Centro por NBC. Muchísimas gracias por haber estado aquí en Noches con Platanito. Amigos, ya lo saben, si les gustó este video, denle like y suscríbanse. Compártanlo también. Oigan, si les gustó, qué bueno. Y si no, pues se los va a cargar el payaso. ¡Ay, güey!